I'm finally going to do the room tour. Now, I've been thinking about this, but I just added in another section of shelves and I'm out of space. So this is it. There's not much more that I can do. So I've gone from using the two largest rooms in my house that were in the basement for my record collection, and it spread into both of those rooms and filled them up, to now putting my record collection in the smallest room in the house in my office. So I need to have room for a desk. So it's been a journey. This has been an incredible journey as I've had to rechange how I collect records, what I buy, my thought process, getting rid of records to make room for something new. So today, we're going to take a look at having a record collection in a very tiny little room. There, you just saw the whole record collection. But let's go into a little bit more. Okay, so we're going to begin here. And this is a rock music. You know, it just starts in A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M. It's pretty much alphabetical order. You could see that these bins here are fairly tight. You know, there's a little room. I just added 12 more cubes to open this up. And it's hard to believe that I was able to, because it still seems very, very tight in here. You know, this is it. I'm out of room, so now I have to make do with what I have. You can see, just still buy box sets, but I buy a whole lot less box sets. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a link on in my description of a room tour that I did downstairs. So if you're interested to see what it used to look like, you can see what it looks like now. Now, my albums are usually pushed back in because I like to put the albums out front, something out front. It's nice to look at. You know, album artwork is special. And I like to look at this. This actually here, one, two, three, and four, that's a rap and soul and funk. So I do have those four cubes are set up over here. Kind of should have put them down there, maybe. I don't know. There's my CD box sets. But you can see how tight, you know, I got a picture that I had painted in Puerto Rico, but this gets to be very tight in here. So when you're trying to get at something, especially when you're on the bottom, it's really it gets difficult. But that's just what you got to deal with. So we make do. You know, down here, this is just stuff waiting. That's 2 weeks. That's stuff I'm listening to. You know, new stuff. A few albums I'm making decisions on, but basically new stuff that I need to play. That's for an upcoming video. There's another upcoming video. There's an upcoming video. So try to have them lined up. As far as equipment, there is a Kenwood here CD player. I believe I got that from Greg, Three Dimensions of Sound. The stereo system here, the Pioneer receiver. This came from Brother Brian after the flood. I went to his house and I've never seen so much stereo equipment. He also gave me a realistic speaker. And by the way, Greg, Three Dimension Sound, he gave me other stereo equipment too that I've set up downstairs. And then we have he gave me ELAC speakers. And he gave me another set of speakers also. And of course, they're on a stand. So really nice. You know, the sound's great. I'm happy with it, no complaints. So, and it's a little room. I don't need a lot of power in this little room. Here's the desk. You can see, Yeah, I got trash on the floor. I need to pick that up. How about that? Now, you know, I do have a closet here, and it's, you know, usually you should always shut doors and never let people look in your closet. But the fact is, I love games. And I got games from, there's a Godfather's game. How about that? Square Mile. There's games from the 60s, 70s in here that I had as a kid. I did lose games while I was, you know, in the flood, but a lot of them I kept were up here. I had some really nice military board games, but those pretty much got destroyed. So I have all that. There's just my supplies, my cleaning stuff. And yeah, that's whole. There's some G.I. Joes in there, but it's a lot of crap that I use. Down here, I got these three boxes. And in these three boxes, and these are all burned CDs. These are almost all bootlegs in here, in all three boxes. And Doc Burns, out of the Baltimore area after the flood, he is a massive, massive collector of bootleg. And he burned CDs for me, or had extras. And all three of these boxes are packed with bootleg CDs. And I use them in my car all the time. I'm always pulling from here and bringing them to use in my vehicle. So really, really nice from Doc Burns. And it was, Doc, if you're watching this, it was sure good to hear from you again. I'm glad everything's going good for you. So again, here's more of the rock. You can see I have room for a little bit. But right now, you know, quite honestly, I am walking through the cubes and deciding what I need to get rid of, because there's not a lot of room. And even here, that crate there, that is stuff I haven't shown on the early morning Sunday show. And some of that goes back quite a ways, but you know, it's just stuff I haven't shown. So now over here, this is the newest cube, or a couple cubes that I just brought in. You can see that. I put this up on Sunday, and look at that, how full they became. So what you have is over here, this is jazz. That's all my jazz. And this, that's soundtracks, reggae, Brazilian, and then African. That is all analog Africa right there. Here's some of the jazz box sets that I've had. Nice Miles Davis one. Bob Mould, there's all four boxes of Bob Mould and some Ooskadoo, just in case you don't have. And my Pride and Joy by Luna box set. So we got some cool stuff there. Those cases are full of CDs that I saved from the flood. Just obviously do not have anything else that goes with them. In this section, I have this. These are all my rock books. So this had been a bookcase. A bookcase that I had basically a lot of books. That's now in my bedroom. I have a giant bedroom. I actually could have made a huge, I should have just made that my record room. It would have been huge. But so instead, we have now, so these are various biographies, different music books, and whatever else that I have there. Here is more biographies that I have. Different awards from work. Then these are my reference sources. These are my Bibles that I really love. I love to look in, I love to read them. I do research with them. And then we get down, and this gets really full. There's my grandson. I don't have room for CDs. I have a couple bigger boxes of CDs and other stuff just stacked around. I don't know what to do with. I have to figure that out. They're going to have to go someplace else. But you can see those are all just Miles Davis box sets. The only thing that survived the flood, Coltrane and Davis, which I'm very, very happy. Down here, just CDs that I had. You can see they're stacked a couple deep in there. And then some more different box sets. I've tried to go with some of these. You know, when you, instead of buying a whole bunch of, you know, all the albums, sometimes you can get a box set that has all the different albums in there and take up a lot less space. This is classical. And I do have more classical that's not in there. And then all my 45s are contained within just that one box. Some of the 45s I saved from the flood, and then some are new. I actually have bought a couple of them that I use. Here, those albums right there, those actually were in the front of the cases, but I wanted to show you how full the cases were. Here I have country, western, and I have blues. So they're both mixed up in there. That's my chair, which is a very comfy, very nice chair that we always do the early morning show on. So this is it in a nutshell. Now, I have some stuff in another room, and let's go look at that.
Okay, so a spare bedroom, and I have this case. All of this white, these are records that I don't have covers to. I'd like to get covers to them, but I haven't found them. Or, you know, I'll buy a new reissue, and I'll take it out, and I'll put it in. So, you know, and some of these aren't hard to find. You know, War, but I now have a box set of it. You know, Milo, Das, I mean, talk about a cheap album. Get Ben Folds, Songs for Silverman. That thing's very expensive now. Flaming Groovies, that's the first one. Some Jenny Lewis. Led Zeppelin Bootleg. Krungman. Richard Hell, Destiny Street. More Led Zeppelin Bootlegs. That's going to be almost impossible. Five. The Leaves of Hey Joe, some Green Day, Peter Gabriel, Passion, Fuzz, Eleanor Friedberg. That's very expensive. Robert Fripp Exposure, cheap. Future Island Singles, that's gotten expensive. Sonita, Rodriguez Gabriela. So you could see Nine Inch Nails, Churchill's, The Clean. That's a beautiful copy on the Flying Nun record label. Clear Light Symphony, Collected Soul, Unknown Pleasures. So a variety of them. I can't go through it. That was a record store day one. The Wombats, I think, was for big bucks now. The Verlaines, again, original Flying Nun, Breaks Your Heart. Loaded. I should be able to put that into a sleeve. Steppenwolf's Spaceman 3, Sound of Confusion. Wow. That thing, if you want, it goes for a ton of money. So, yeah, this is what I got. Still looking. I used to have them in the rack, but to make room, I put them out. You got classical box sets are under back behind there, which I actually like. Music, I'm trying to decide on whether to get rid of or not. I'm going to have to get rid of a whole lot here so I can bring in more. So I do know a lot of you have a lot less space, and you find a way to make it happen. You have to limit the size of your collection. For me, this was just, it was a huge adjustment going from having so much room. But when you start with nothing, it's a little easier. It's just within 3 years, this has filled up to over 3,000 albums. So someone has overspent, let's say that. But a lot of these were gifts from you, and which I really appreciate. I mean, after the flood, you know, hundreds of albums did pour in to start up my collection. And those I keep because those are important to me. But, you know, other ones that I bought, maybe I've decided I really don't like that. I don't really need that. And then I got to make decisions. So, yeah, it's gotten definitely a lot tighter. But you make do for what you have. And you just have to make more decisions. So, there we go. My record room, which you can just spin around and do. Huh. That's from Andre, Linda Legg, that blues poster. Isn't that cool? And Tino gave me that little painting he did there. So, all right, there we go. Okay. Thank you for popping in and joining me. And we'll see you. I got actually something coming up on Thursday. Bye.